right, guys, listen up.
The easiest road for you to tread will be to walk up the old creek bed. After that, they're searching still. Take a left at the stump and head up the hill.
Done that.
Find the Devil's Fork and your request is complete. Go 15 paces due south and it's under your
feet. We found it, baby!
So after the last reward challenge, we finally got a third and final piece of our map for the treasure chest, and we were just bouncing off the walls, ready to find it.
I'm hoping there's candy and maybe some canned juice and peaches and pineapples in there. I don't know. Anything but rice. If I see one more grain of rice, I'll be upset. I'm gonna go wild.
We talk about the treasure, we dream about the treasure, we fantasize about the treasure. Like, I've had more wet dreams about that treasure than any girl in Playboy.
Roof, anything?
No.
But
it's here.
Yeah. It's gotta be here.
It's out all by itself?
I don't know. That, to me, looks like a fork out in the open, to be honest.
Why is this not jumping out?
Look at this map. Come back here and look at this map.
We have not found it yet. We're still back to the same dilemma we've been in the whole time, which is the directions say find the Devil's Fork. The clues say go 15 paces due south. The map shows going 15 paces due north, but there's no obvious Devil's Fork out here.
Does that look like a Devil's Fork to you? If you think of what's in here, there's nothing else as big and obtrusive as that thing right there.
I'm buying that.
What?
What about over here?
It is really soft.
Feeling anything? Is that it?
It's like wood.
Dude, I think this might be it. Look, there's metal. See?
He's digging.
I think I got it.
We got it. It's over here. Flat.
So show me a Devil's Fork.
It's right there.
Right there, baby.
At that big tree.
Look at it from the other side.
John, you're a god.
Yeah, baby.
We've won three challenges. We've gotten three maps. We've searched this island high and low. And here it was. We were standing on the freaking treasure.
Barbecue potato chips.
Ooh. 8 pair of pants.
Bacon cheeseburgers. New underpants.
I'll be happier when I see what's in there.
Hold on, dude, hold on.
There is a handle.
What if you could just open the top? Is it possible? No. So after trying to bring the chest up, they said, okay, the hell with it, screw this, let's pop the chest open. When they cleared away the lock.
Just be careful with our keys.
Just don't break it. And finally it popped open. And oh my God. A stench so awful, smelled like death.
Hey, someone open this.
Should we lay out a blanket and put everything? Oh, God.
It smells horrible.
They're moldy. Horrible.
Everything's moldy and nasty.
They're all molded.
Hey, it's better than nothing, you guys.
Oh, a bottle of something.
Yeah.
Candy out.
I have to say, the one thing that put a smile on everyone's face, and thank God it was in there, was this thing of chocolates. I mean, I think we would have ripped each other's heads off if those chocolates weren't in there, because that's how disappointed we were.
We're gonna take a break. Everybody sit back and
my God.
I'm in heaven.
So we open it up. There were goblets, candle holders, candles. We got a lot of canned food. There's sugar, there's honey.
Sugar!
Moldy beef jerky.
Some coffee beans. There were some chocolates, which made everyone feel a lot better. The treasure had leaked a little bit. Some of the stuff was wet. And I wanted to say, guys, grow up. You're being babies about it. We got something, and anything is better than nothing.
The blankets smell like crap. The hammock smells like crap. The mosquito net smells like crap. I'd call it a ghetto Christmas. It's like asking for an Incredible Hulk doll and getting your sister's Ken doll painted green. It's just not the same thing.